If you have a recent Haas machine, it very likely has one of these here on the pendant, a USB port for transferring files into machine memory. If you have problems or get alarms related to the USB not working, here are some things you can check to pinpoint the problem. The first place to check is to try several different USB sticks to see if they all have the same problem. There can be compatibility issues when using USB drives from different suppliers. We find that more often than not, USB read errors can be traced back to the brand of drive used. And when these are changed to a compatible drive, the problems go away. It's an easy place to start, and it's the most likely reason for this kind of issue. Once you've tried a few USB sticks and none of them connect to the control, this is a good indication that we have some kind of issue with the machine. There is one more thing we need to check before we get to the machine itself. Here at the factory, when we get these USB bulkhead cables back after service calls, rarely do they actually have a problem. In some cases, we've received cables from multiple machines out of the same shop with none of them being bad. Sometimes, grounding and electrical interference issues have been found. When these were fixed, it rectified the USB read errors. A quick way to check if this might be the problem is to cycle power to the machine and then check if the USB stick reads correctly. If it does, then it's a good idea to check for grounding or interference issues before moving on. Something like a welder in use on the same circuit as the machine is an example of a possible source of interference. Additionally, we've put links to some related troubleshooting documents in the description for this video. Once we've verified our USB devices are good and we don't have electrical issues, it's time to get to the machine. First, let's look at how the data from the USB stick reaches the main con board on the machine. I've powered the machine down and waited for the LED here on the vector drive to go out before beginning any of this work. This ensures there isn't any dangerous voltage present. At the back of the operator pendant with the back cover off, we can see that the USB port is at one end of this cable here. This cable connects to the serial keyboard interface card, or SCBIF for short. From there, another cable continues into the main control cabinet. The cable ends up at the main con board plugged into this port here at the top. Now that I know the pathway, I can check each connection to find out where the fault is. I already know that the connection at the side of the control doesn't work. So I'll disconnect the cable here at the SCBIF and plug in my USB stick. Now, I'll power the machine back up and check if I can see my USB stick connected to the control. If I get a good connection here, I know that the cable going to the side of the pendant needs to be replaced. If I don't see my USB stick, then I need to keep going to the main con board. I'll power the machine down again, wait for the vector drive LED to go dark, then I'll remove the intermediate USB cable where it connects to the main con, and I'll connect my USB stick directly to the main con. Now I power up the machine. If my USB stick connects, I obviously know the main con USB connection is good. If the USB stick doesn't connect, I potentially have a problem with the main con USB connection. If this is the case, it's time to call your HFO. Let's assume in this case that the USB stick connects correctly to the main con. The last component we can easily test here at the machine is the pendant side cable. So we'll power down the machine again, wait for the LED to dim, remove the USB cable from the pendant, and reconnect the cable to the USB input on the main con, and plug in the USB stick. Power up the machine. If the USB stick reads, you know that this cable is good. If the USB stick does not read, you'll need to replace this cable. The intermediate cable and the SCBIF card are more difficult to test here. If the pendant side cable and the main con board check out good, you'll need to contact your Haas factory outlet so that they can come and test whether the intermediate cable or the SCBIF are at fault. Another way to double check both cables is to connect them to another device, like a laptop with USB ports. If they check out there, you know they're not the problem. That wraps up the testing we can do here at the machine. If you have questions or difficulties, don't hesitate to contact your local Haas factory outlet for more help. Thanks for watching.